talk to me, man. It's your boy Young Hope. If you turn the motherfucking noise up, we can get right into the proceedings this evening. Your headphones at the start, bring it down a little bit. Okay, now we working with it. The boy face up in baseline, baby. Smart. Welcome to New York City. It's your boy Young Hope. Chill. Kanye West on the track. Chi-town. What's going on now? Can I talk to y'all for a minute? Let me talk to y'all for a minute. Just give me a minute of your time, baby. I don't want much.
Here is Novella Carpenter, the author of Farm City, The Education of Urban Farmer.
Hi, my name's Novella Carpenter. I'm an urban farmer. I let it fall.
Novella picked Oakland because it's really nice. It has nice weather. The recycling seems pretty good. The music's really good. It's just a good place to start your business.
I have an open farm day every once in a while, and I'm selling my new book, which is The Complete Urban Farmer.
I like the book. It was great.
You know? I'm glad you're reading my book.
It was because I got a chance to think about, you know, some of the things that I'm actually interested in, like farming and like urban farming. So that's one of the things I wanted to do.
I hope you guys, maybe you'll start an urban farm out there at the community college, huh?
I was amazed by how Novella became a farmer, or how she built her farm in the middle of the city. I really liked reading the book and enjoyed it because she showed me that everybody can become a farmer, and then everybody can make their own farm. She's the one who built her own. And she didn't got no help from nobody. So she planted the seeds, she raised the animals, and she was eating like from her own vegetables, and then eating from her own land.
I just bought it last year, and that's why it's a little bit wonky because, you know, we squatted for so long. It was just kind of like we just did everything as cheaply as possible and fast as possible, and did really, you know, planted stuff without really thinking like long term. So now that we own the property, I'm sort of starting to be like, oh my god, I have to like redo everything, and you know, because it doesn't necessarily make sense.
Some of the differences I noticed about the book and the farm. Like when we went to the farm, I thought the chickens would be inside the farm and not in her backyard.
The chickens are actually in the backyard, and I don't take people into the backyard.
I think it's good to have a farm. You could just grow your own food and just live off the land. Grow your own chicken, rabbit, and just not have to go to a supermarket all the time to buy food.
It's a quality of life thing, you know? So it's like, if I didn't have this garden, then I'd just like sit in my apartment, you know what I mean? So it's nice to have a garden.
The beehive, I thought it was on top of like a balcony or something in her house. But the beehive was downstairs in the farm. And lots of the animals, like the pigs, rabbits and those kind of things, I didn't see at the farm.
You know, I actually did just get rid of my goats there because I couldn't take care of them and the baby at the same time. Mm-hmm. I don't raise turkeys anymore because the turkeys, they get away. They like wander off too much, you know, so they're too much work. But I do like the turkeys.
I thought it was neat how she just learned how to be a farmer from reading books at the library and learning from other people. I thought it was cool how she just got all her pig food and all her animal food from going dumpster diving and just recycling everything. She tried to reuse everything she could.
Yeah, yeah, isn't that crazy?
And that's it.
Reading the book, it was, it gave me the idea of about farming, and mainly I thought the farm was like big farm, like, you know, like, and I was imagining there are many, plenty of chickens in there, plenty of ducks and geese and all that kind of stuff. But when we went in reality and actually watched the plot of land or the yard, I mean, I find it so incomparable, like, it is so small. And I thought it was exaggerated so much on the book. Another thing was, she talked up in the book about self-reliance, and I was trying to figure it out, how could she be self-reliant on that small plot of, you know, land? I mean, it's so small, and her to talk about self-reliance was not really, it didn't catch my attention. There was a connection, there was some things I found. The connection was about the neighborhood. She explained the neighborhood and the gravity in that area and the dangerousness of that area. All that did match up, and I did not have any, you know, problems on that. And I could imagine the place when reading in the book, and then it was the same thing in reality. That was all good.
She talked about the coin statue. I'm not sure how she put the statue. So when I really go to the farm, and then I saw that she put the coin statue on the floor. For me, it's part of the religion, so it's like really big deal for me. I mean, I know she's not supposed to put on the floor, which is like dirty, and then, you know. I mean, she did it, but I can't mad at her because everyone have a different religion and belief in stuff. So.
Thanks for coming. It's good to see all the students.
New young girl, de mama dove away. New young girl, de mama dove away. New young girl, de mama dove away. New young girl, de mama dove away.
My second bottle, hope I don't catch a homo. Grossing I net simultaneously, making me climb higher. Heinous crimes behind me, search but can't find me. Fuck sadness, had this been you having this lavish habitual happiness at me, you wouldn't look back, which you would have sex on condominium roof decks. So anyone move next, I hit you with two texts. Rockin' Roberto Cavalli, no shirt or convertible. Mozzie, my Colombiana, mommy riding beside me. Every tap means something, that's my word on my body. I have to lean something with that my spurt shotty. My niggas is ignorant, put lead in your pigment. Just cause y'all was mad at all the years I was getting it. And 9-7 to 6, 9-8 to Bentley. Now it's the Ghost Phantom, and y'all can't stand him, but.